Marco Peroni and Chris Constantino are the Wolfmen. I met them at Razor Studios to talk about the future, the present, and the past. Because Modernity Killed Every Night, as your debut album, came out sort of late-ish last year, August last year. And but we were thinking about when you guys came together as the Wolfmen.
Right.
Which I was suggesting it was 2004, but we're thinking maybe it's sort of more like...
Wrong.
I was suggesting wrong.
Yeah. I think it was 2006, was it?
I don't know. I don't know where I was last week. It's all kind of, it's all very organic, as they say. It just sort of happened with no real plans to do anything.
So I think we're thinking that it's, what's also with the Wolfmen is it's you coming together again. Sort of coming sort of X years on, having sort of, had you met before?
No, I don't think so. Yes, we've met before.
Yeah. Have you met before?
No, not before we worked.
I mean, did you when you worked with Adam Ant?
No, I came for an audition. I saw. I think I was playing in this band called Drill, who was signed to RCA, and our press person was at CBS and said, "Oh, they're looking for a bass player." Blah blah blah, and everyone else had joined the famous bands in the Drill. So sort of that time I did as well. Mm. So I sort of went off and did this audition, and then sort of went off and we did some tours and eventually made Viva La Rock.
I was imagining with that whole period when you were there, like, does it actually take, I mean it's probably, I would imagine it's taken a number of years to actually look back on it with any, not necessarily clarity, but at the was it a sort of such a time where you're sort of, the hit records are all, you know, you're writing strings of hit records, there's a lot of adulation, there's a lot of attention.
Yeah.
Are you, when you're in the midst of that, are you aware, are you?
It seems very normal, because it's all very gradual, you know. It's not like one day you're in, you're in a club and the next day you're playing huge venues. You know, the venues start getting bigger, you know, suddenly there's more people on your crew, suddenly you find yourself in business class and then you find yourself in first class. It's all like that, it kind of, it's all, almost like you don't notice it. It's only when you sit, you sort of, it only struck me once in Japan. I was in the hotel room and like I just sort of looking out the window of the sort of Tokyo skyline and I thought, how did I get here? It's like 18 months ago, I was in a, you know, sitting at home with an acoustic guitar. Now
it seems that Cecilia has had people trying to sort of put a lot onto it, hasn't it? Had one of these hyphenated descriptions of something like psychedelic electro. Pop.
It's one of the worst descriptions of it.
I like the description. It's completely inaccurate, but that's
right. Nice use of words.
I don't know. What do you think? You've heard it, haven't you? Yeah. What's your description of it? Do you think that fits it?
Well, the trouble is, I read the critique first, and then was trying to fit psychedelic electro pop. Too.
Maybe it is. I don't know. It's got flutes. It's got weird sort of.
It's whatever you want it to be, really.
Guitars.
I'm happy for it to be anything. You know.